biggest fear, number two, was I won't be able to be a mother again. And that was quite devastating for me. But then I realized there are so many children in the world, all they want is acceptance. So there is no point of crying, just go and adopt one. And that's what I did. I gave my name in different organizations, different orphanages. I didn't mention that I'm on a wheelchair, dying to have a child. So I just told them that this is Muniba Mazari and she wants to adopt a boy or girl whatsoever, but I want to adopt a kid. And I waited patiently. 2 years later, I got this call from a very small city in Pakistan. I got a call and they said, are you Muniba Mazari? There is a baby boy and would you like to adopt? Now when I say yes, I could literally feel the labor pain. I said, yes, yes, I am going to adopt him. I am coming to take him home. There, the man was sitting and he was looking at me from head to toe. And in back of my head, I kept thinking that, oh my God, he's going to say she's on the wheelchair, she doesn't deserve it. How is she going to take care of him? And I looked at him and I said, do not judge me because I'm on the wheelchair. But you know what he said? He said, I know you will be the best mother of this child. You both are lucky to have each other. Nile was 2 years old, 2 days old, and today he's six. You'll be surprised to know another bigger fear that I had in me. It was facing people. I used to hide myself from people. When I was on bed for 2 years, I used to keep the door closed. I used to pretend that I'm not going to meet anyone, tell them that I'm sleeping. You know why? Because I couldn't stand that sympathy that they had for me. They used to treat me like a patient. When I used to smile, they used to look at me and say that, you're smiling, are you okay? I was tired of this question being asked, are you sick? Well, a lady yesterday at the airport asked me, are you sick? And I said, well, besides the spinal cord injury, I'm fine, I guess. Those are really cute questions. They never used to feel cute when I was on the bed. So I used to hide myself from people, knowing that, oh my God, I'm not going to see that sympathy in their eyes. It's all right. And today I'm here speaking to all these amazing people because I have overcome the fear. Do you know when you end up being on the wheelchair, what's the most painful thing? That's another fear that people on the wheelchair or the people who are differently abled have in their hearts, but they never share. I'll share that with you. The lack of acceptance. People think that they will not be accepted by other people because we, in the world of perfect people, are imperfects. So I decided that instead of starting an NGO for disability awareness, which I know will not help anyone, I started to appear more in public. I started to paint. I always wanted to. I've done a lot of exhibitions. I'm Pakistan's first wheelchair-bound artist. I've done a lot of modeling campaigns, different campaigns for brands like Tony and Guy. I have done some really funny, breaking the barriers kind of modeling